Right, so today I am adding in this lovely yarn, which is either a King Cole or a Stourport or a Woolcraft or a Regia or a West Yorkshire Spinner. I have lost the ball band because it's from Stash. I don't tend to save them really, I'm so bad. But yeah, so that's what I'm adding in today, and that's already coming up really lovely with the yellow. So that's the yellow from yesterday, and yeah, ignore the little hole where I've added in the yarn. That needs to be tidied up, and I'm going to do sort of the end tidy up video, kind of showing how I do it, which may or may not be perfect, I don't know. You know, it might be helpful to you in some way. If you add in yarn, you might find it helpful, you know. There's probably lots of people out there doing videos on how to tidy up, how to add in yarn, how to do this, how to do that. So you could check somebody else's out if you're not happy with mine. Oops, oh dear, Bubbles is being a bit naughty. I think there's a cat in the other garden. Right, so tomorrow I'm going to be adding this yarn in, and this is a Stourport yarn. Is it Stourport? No, I think it's Woolcraft, sorry. I have got the ball band somewhere, and I'll show you that tomorrow. Yeah, so at the moment, I'm adding this guy in. Girl, they. Guy, girl, they. Yep. Yes, indeed. There we go. There we have it. Happy knitting for now. This is the add-in for today. And it's this really nice neutral four-ply or fingering yarn from Severn Stitches in Stourport. And it's a Woolcraft yarn. I've got the ball band somewhere. So I will hopefully be able to share that with you. And so far, little carnation, trying to survive. So far, this is where we are with the add-in. Right, okay, yeah, so this is where we are so far with the add-in, and yeah, so that was the heel, and this is what we've done in the previous week, and this is what we're starting off with now this week. So we've got a few days before the weekend and before we do the toe. In the meantime, I was knitting on the other sock as well, so let me just show you that. Yeah, so this is the other sock, and what I had done is I'd forgotten to add the green in down here somewhere. I was wondering why it wasn't as long as the other one by the time I got to this colourway, and it was because I hadn't added the green in, so I've added that in up here, so it's slightly different from the other sock. And if we put them together, let me just show you. Yeah, so when we put them together, you can see a slight difference there. So this one, we've got the green here, we've got the green up here. So yes, we're going to knit on the rest of the foot and then add in the heel. No, not heel, toes. And then it will be a matter of sewing in, covering up these. Oh, well, it's not covering, but it's like sewing in the ends. Let me just show you, for instance, that sort of thing where two yarns, well, where you've changed the yarn, so you've got two yarn ends. And hopefully I'll be showing you what I'm doing with that as well. Yeah, so it is looking... Oop, where's that coming from? It is looking good. Thank you. it's pumpkin season and we've got our pumpkins in ready to carve. Sharing my progress so far, I've knitted in the pink and I did retrieve for this yarn the ball band to show you as promised. So it's a Woolcraft superwash sock yarn, knits to 4-ply, and what's the colour? Okay, there doesn't seem to be a colourway, it's a dye lot apparently, and a shade, and that's it. It's a bit sad, I like it when they name them things, to be honest. And that's the recommended needle is 3 1/4. I'm not using a 3 1/4, I'm using a 2.75 because it's a sock. I kind of want it to knit tight. But if you were to knit a jumper or something, or a scarf would probably be even looser than that, to be fair, but a jumper would be 3 1/4 would be fine for a jumper, I would say. So it's a superwash and it's got some polyamide to make it strong, and those are the washing instructions. And generally I put my knitted socks on a 30 degree, not even a 40 degree, to be honest. Yeah. And I don't usually spin them either. Or I'll hand wash them. So that's that one. And the add-in today is going to be this one, another Woolcraft superwash sock 4-ply. And again, it's only a dye lot, there's no colorway. And I got this and this guy from Severn Stitches in Stourport. Lovely little wool shop, lovely owner. So get down there if you're down that way at any time and get some yarn. Yeah. So I will be back when I've knitted some of this in, I expect. Yeah, so that was the pink, and I'll just, oops, gives me wire. That was the colour. I only had a little bit of it, and I think this was a Nord again, a drops one, but I can't be sure. So, on to the next. Yeah, so yesterday I added in this lovely bluey toned colourway. And I kind of wanted to get the different blues. So rather than just one blue, I've got like a cobalt blue, I've got a aqua blue or a turquoise type blue, and then here I've got a more purpley blue. So hopefully I've got all those tones in the sock. And then today I have added in this King Cole yarn, which I also got from, where was it? Severn Stitches in Stourport. So that is one of the yarns as well, and it's a kind of a Christmassy colour really, I'd say, but I think a little bit in a helical knit won't be too Christmassy, but Christmas is around the corner, let's face it. And so far the red's gone in and I'm just onto the green bit, so there's some green there, but now I've got to the time when I've got to put the heel in. So toe. Oop. Start that again. Yeah, so even though I've just started on the green, I've now got to the point, because the foot area is now long enough to put the toe in. So I've decided to not go with a new colour and just use the colourway I used for the cuff. So I'm reusing that colourway for the toe area. and I'm going to be popping that in tomorrow and Sunday, so that's going to be going in over the weekend, and it should really be completed, but I expect it will totally be completed by Monday. So I'm hoping to share that, you know, this coming week, the end of it. Yeah, I'll probably share it as a little short or something, or a slightly smaller video, just to confirm the final sock, if you like. But yeah, what I did want to do today was to show you how to weave in those ends that are created by adding in another colour. So for instance, hang on, so this sort of thing really. So here you've got two colours, and there's different ways you can add in. I mean, there's the spit and splice, which sounds gruesome, and I haven't really tried it, to be honest with you, because of that. I'm probably being silly, and I'm not quite sure how to do it, but I'll have to research that and have a look. But I usually just add a colour in with a tail, as you can see, and then I will weave that into the knitting, and I'm just going to show you how to do that. So I'm just showing you how to weave in the ends of the colour that was there and you snapped off, and the new colour that you joined in. So you will usually have two ends in the same place. So I've got a white and I've got a pink. So the white is going to follow the pink yarn through the stitches, and the pink is going to follow the white. So if we take the white in, where are we? Right, here we are. Oops, need to keep that in the middle. Where are we? I'm afraid I've got a bit of a funny camera angle, so I hope you can see this. Yeah, so this is following the pink. There we go. Oop, can you see? It's going fuzzy. So what you have is you've got this bottom row of stitches, which is a light blue, and then the top is a blue. So you've got to kind of work out those stitches, and then the yarn is weaving round those two rows of stitches, basically making its own row, and that is what you're weaving into. I've put a bit of pink there, haven't I? Oops, that's not good. Right, put it back in the middle. Sorry, this is on the hoof. I just wanted to get this in because, you know. Right, yeah. Are we making a pig's ear of it, or are we doing all right? Yeah, I think we are. Hang on, let me just thread this up again. Off camera for a minute. Ooh, that's a right tricky business this is, I tell you. It's tricky enough doing it without a camera. In your face, as it were, or in your fingers. Right, so that's the top of the stitch there, and that's going into, and it's become sort of a red colour now, hasn't it, from pink to red. So, you know, there is a change of colour, so you know, you have to fit that, as it were. So I think I'll do a short on how to weave in the ends with a better camera angle. So that wasn't a very good camera angle. Some of you may have got it and some of you may not have got it. Actually, that's a good one to do because you can really see the stitches. There's good contrast. But you know, there's not always going to be that good a contrast. So the main thing to think about is the rows of stitches. You know, there'll be two, and this is sort of the row in between wherever these are coming from. And this yarn would go into, oops, this yarn would go into this yarn stitches, and this yarn would go into this yarn stitches. So that sort of thing, really. But yeah, I might do a short after I put this video out. yeah. Yeah, so the next thing on these socks will be to just finish them off, and I'm going to do that. It will be the toe, and it will be, oops, sorry, getting all tangled up now, and it will be in this yarn. And sharing will hopefully be on Monday or next week sometime, so we'll see. Yeah. They'll be finished on Monday, hopefully shared by Monday. Right, they look like a big mess now, so let's bring in something neat. Yay, this is neat. These look neater. Yes, they do. Anyway, happy knitting.